Hello guys, let us solve this problem on HackerRank called array.findAll and array.findData. So basically what we have to do in this problem is, see, they are giving us some input string, and from this string we have to, actually I'm going to split this into the pattern, whatever I'm going to use in the regex expression, I'm going to split it into three types. One is going to be the consonants, followed by the vowels, followed by the consonants, because they have mentioned particularly that between the vowels they want consonants, right? So actually between consonants they want vowels. So basically, when we find a consonant, and after that, whenever we find a vowel and the vowel string continues, we have to end it whenever we find a consonant afterwards, right? So this is going to be the pattern. We are going to split it in three parts, and then we'll write the regex expression, and we have to basically print out the series of vowels. So obviously for that, I'll have to define some vowels and consonants. So let us try to code it now. So first of all, about this, I'll tell you all afterwards. So first of all, let us have s equals to, say, input string, whatever you have. After that, I want vowels and consonants. So for those vowels and consonants, see, I already have copied these strings, which this is a vowel string and this is a consonant string. But the thing is, they have told us that they can be uppercase as well. So for that, we'll use ignore case in the flag. That will be in the next part. So let us say we'll use re.findData. So, and for that, obviously, I'll have to import re. So first of all, in the first line, let us import re. And after that, let us try to use re.find function. So re.findAll. And so you can see over here, they want pattern, string and flags. So first of all, we want to define the pattern. So I'll just write pattern so that we understand. Then the string is going to be s, because I already have taken input of s. And then the flag. So flag is nothing but I want to set it as array.ignoreAll. Sorry, not ignoreAll, ignore case. So yeah, this one. Because of this ignore case, we are basically considering AIO in capital, caps lock as well as small. So that's fine. Now s is defined, flags is defined. Now we just have to see about the pattern. What should be the pattern? So obviously let us use a raw string for that. So inside the double quotes, I'll write double quotes, raw string. Now as I told you, I'm going to split this into three parts, right? First part is going to be, so this is the first part, this is the second part, this is the third part. First part is going to be consonant, then vowel, then consonant. So I'll just use a percentage sign, that's modulo, then simply consonant, then vowel, then consonant. CVC means this C, V and C. That's why I already took this C, V and C. So that's why now let us see what to do in it. So for these consonants, I'm going to use this thing. So question mark less than equal to sign. So what does this mean? It means that it matches the current position in the string if it is preceded by a match. So basically, I'm going to use this. So question mark equals to, sorry, less than equals to. Okay, now I want to use a string. So for that, I will specify square brackets. And inside of it, I'll write percent s. And this percent s, basically this first square brackets means this consonants. So it will be likewise, the first bracket is done. Now the second bracket is going to be vowels, because I want vowels in it. But obviously vowels is also going to be a string, percent s. So percent s. But the thing over here is they want two or greater than two vowels, right? So for that we'll use a curly braces. So two curly braces, open and close. We'll start from two and we'll just go ahead. So we'll just start from two, that's it. In this way we got two vowels. So basically this found consonants. Now it will find for the vowels, but they will be two or greater than two in this way. And now the consonant. So for consonants, it is nothing but really easy. So basically what we'll do, simply use a normal string. So percent s. But remember, this percent s will be linked to this c. So basically consonants, vowels and then consonants. So obviously when I use this array.findAll function, if you see in the, yeah, over here in the theory, they have actually told us that if you see, this findAll returns a list. So let us store it as a list now. So what variable, I'll say l equals to this array.findAll. First of all, let us do one thing. Let us try to print l and see what happens. So I'll just run this code and let us check if our logic is right or wrong. The pattern that we used is right or wrong. So I'll just copy this thing. So copy and paste it, enter. So yeah, if you see, we got the vowels as they are needed. So E, E, I, O, whatever it is. If you see, they have printed it on new line. So for printing them on new line, you can use join function. Basically, the syntax is kind of like this. So print, or if you don't know this join function, I'm going to tell you by one more method. So please wait for that. So first of all, I'll use print. First of all, the iterable that I want, or the string actually. So the string is going to be on a new line. I want to print it on a new line. New line means nothing but the backslash n. Then dot join function. And now inside of this join function, I'll specify by what do I want to join them. So what I want to join, I want to join this l, or if this l does not exist, that is if l is empty, then I'll print out minus 1. That's what I'm supposed to do. But actually, what do I mean by this l or minus 1? It just means that if this l is empty, basically if you don't find any vowels, then they have told us to print out minus 1. I I'll have to find it where they have told us. Yeah, so if you see, if no match is found, you have to print out minus one. So basically, if you find no match, if no match is found, the list L will be empty list, right? So L means if it exists, then it will print out the by joining it on new line. But if L does not exist, that is, if L is empty list, then it will print out minus one. So now let us run this code and see what happens. So I'll just paste it. Yeah, so if you see, we got it. And this was by using the join function. Now let us try to use by some other method, because join method can get confusing sometimes. So I'll do one thing, I'll use if conditions for that. So if I'll say if L is empty list, right? So if L equals to an empty list, which is nothing but this thing, what I'm going to do, I'm going to print out minus one, because obviously they have told us if it is not found, that is, if it is empty list, I'll print out minus one. Else I'm going to simply use a for loop to print out the values. That is really easy, right? So for any I in L, that is, I'm traversing through all the string and I'm going to print out I on a new line. So I'll just run this code and let us see if it is same as the join function. So paste it. Yeah, I pasted it, hit enter. If the output is same. So actually, one more thing, if you for doing some changes in it, because L equals to empty list, this is nothing, it is nothing but if not L. So you can write if not L, or you can write if L equals to empty list, it is going to be the same thing. So paste it again. If you see, yeah, it is working. So let's copy this code and paste it on HackerRank so that we can see if all the test cases are working or no. I'll submit it directly. Okay, this don't need this, but it is fine. The comment, yeah, each and every test case are satisfied, there's no error. So that's all from my side. You can subscribe to our channel for more program related content, electronics content, to get updates about it. So that's all. Stay tuned and keep learning. Thank you.